Hi, I'm Eddie of Eddie's Reef Aquaria. Today's video is on the Gorgonia that I recently purchased. I'm going to talk a little bit of them. I'm going to talk about that there's two types, the photosynthetics, which are this one, and the non-photosynthetic types. I'm also going to go ahead and give you a walk around on the tank and show you what I have changed. As people that follow me know that when it comes to gluing corals, I don't glue or epoxy all of them, maybe just a couple of them. And the reason of this is that if I need to move them around because of issues like they need more light or more flow or the reverse, then I can go ahead and move them around and I don't have to pry them off or nothing. So what I'm going to do is, besides give you a little data when it comes to the Gorgonias, I'm also going to show you the change is what I have actually done when it comes to corals. So I hope you enjoy this video and let's take a deep dive into the video. Hold on 1 second. Okay, and this is what I found out when it comes to Gorgonias. Like I mentioned in the intro, there's two types. There's the photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic types. Now, this one you're looking at is the photosynthetic type of Gorgonia. Now, most, and I would safely say all of them that are photosynthetics type of Gorgonias come from the Atlantic Ocean region. The non-photosynthetic types of Gorgonias come from the Pacific Oceans, like the Indonesia area, Hawaii, Tonga, and Philippines, and on and on. So when you go to your LFS, and you go ahead and you purchase a Gorgonia, make sure that you ask, are they photosynthetic or non-photosynthetic? And chances are that when they say photosynthetic, as I'm reiterating right now, they are from the Atlantic Ocean region, the Caribbean, and so forth. If they're non-photosynthetic type of Gorgonias, then rest assured that they definitely are from the Pacific Ocean. Now here's what happens. Knowing photosynthesis, how it works by the light. They actually feed from the light. So these Gorgonias, like the one that you're viewing right now, are very easy to be kept. One of the main reasons is when it comes to feeding. And all Gorgonias, the majority, all of them, really, if you were to scuba dive, go in into the oceans, you will find that they are found in shallow water and with a current. Now, why are the non-photosynthetic not that easy to keep? Okay, being that they're non-photosynthetic, they are from deeper waters. Now, when it comes to the ocean, of course, they have the availability of all the nutrients available that sweeps through them, through the ocean currents. But what happens is, if you try to replicate that in your reef aquarium, what it's telling you is that you need a lot of food. You really have to feed these animals a lot. Then that would be an issue, because then what happens is that then your nutrient level will go up, and that actually would curtail a major issue when it comes to the parameters on your reef aquarium, on your tank. Most of the tanks and most of the research that I have done when it comes to the non-photosynthetic types of Gorgonias in a reef aquarium, they really don't do well. To be honest with you, they don't do well. You really cannot keep them for a long, long period of time, because in habitat, like I was saying, you have to really feed them a lot. And really, to be honest with you, they really don't do well. I personally have had way back the non-photosynthetics. You might recall them by what I'm going to say now. They're the yellow ones. They come in yellow, and the polyps are white. And I've also have purchased ones that are red, and the polyps are also white. And trust me, I've tried everything, and eventually they're very beautiful, they're very nice, but eventually you're going to have issues. So the only thing that I can say when it comes to the non-photosynthetics is that if you're willing to put them on a dedicated tank with other animals that are non-photosynthetic, and you have the proper equipment, and you're going to feed them constantly, every day, then go ahead and try them out. But mostly, commonly, these are the type of gorgonias that you're going to see on reef aquariums. There's another one called sea whip, which are locally found here in Florida, down towards the peninsula, like towards the Keys. And you can find them in different areas also of Florida. But either or, I would really stick with the photosynthetic types, because you really don't have to do much, just have the proper lighting. They do tolerate moderate light because they are from shallow waters. All of them are. And then they do tolerate moderate water flow. This one, as you notice, I place it on the substrate. It's doing great. The little tips, if you notice closely, the little tips are like little whitish, and it's because every day when I see it, there's new growth and growth and growth. If by any chance I see that there's a little issue, then I'll just bring it up to the mid-level or the mid-range, shall we call it, of the reef tank. But so far I've had it for a few weeks and it's doing phenomenal. So that's basically what I wanted to touch when it comes to the gorgonia. Now, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to move the camera back, and then I'm going to show you the changes that I have done when it comes to the coral. So I'm going to pause the video 1 second, and I'll get back to all you guys. Hold on. Okay, now the first change that I'm going to show you, as you're noticing, if you follow me, the lobo. The lobo was a little higher than those zoos that you see on the top of this shot. I brought it down because what was happening is it was too close to the MP10. Now the MP10, I brought it down to 85% of power. I have it on reef crest mode. So it was too much for the lobo, because these corals are either from mid-range down, close to the substrate, and they really don't need a heavy-duty flow. That's mainly for sticks, you know, for acros. So I went ahead and I brought it down, and that rock, I had it there. I had placed it a while back, which I had the purple stylopora, which I also moved to the other side of the tank. So I went ahead and I placed it there. It's not glue. It's just anchored to a section of the rock. Now, if you notice, the zoos, they're creating more and more heads. I had them on the substrate on the bottom where the lobo is now, and I went ahead. Now those zoos, I did glue them. I glued them. I put like a little dab of BSI, which is what I use, and they are glued. And when I got them, they were 4 polyps, and now look, we're up to about 6 polyps. Now these other zoos on the other part of the tank, these still haven't developed new heads. I bought it 3 heads and it's still 3 heads, so that really is stagnant so far. And now the purple stylo, the stylopora that was on the rock where the lobo is now, I went ahead and I placed it here. I did notice that it wasn't opening as much. The polyps that extend beautifully out, they weren't as much. So I went ahead and immediately I took it out where now you see the lobo, and I placed it here, and it's much happier, and it's the polyp extension is much more extended, elongated than before. Now moving on, the This little coral that I've had for quite a while, it's like a phyvitis. I've been moving it around. I had it on the right side of the tank. Now I placed it there. That little coral is not glued. It's just, I went ahead and I wedged it. And every so often during the day, the feelers come out. And a matter of fact, now that I placed it here not too long ago, I'd say about a week ago. I've noticed that it's even happier. It needed eventually more light, because now the little green polyps in the middle that you see, they're actually opening more. They have actually opened much, much more, which curtails that it is doing better, that it's more happier. Now on the left-hand side, the green slimer is not doing too well. I've tried different positioning and all that, but the polyp extension is really not all there. I do everything by the book, as you know that I usually do, and it's not doing well. The only thing that I can attribute to it, I mean, one of the main factors might be when I started to get acros, I really wasn't applying the NeoPhos to the tank, and I wasn't feeding my fish every day. So the tank was quote unquote, as we call it was sterile. There was zero nitrates and zero phosphates. And this is one of the first acros that I actually got. So being that the case, I think that what might have happened is due to the fact that if you follow me, you'll see what I talk about when it comes to phosphates, that you do need a little phosphate and you do need a little bit also of nitrates. But at that point in time, when I got these sticks, I didn't have that. The tank was quote unquote, like I say, sterile. So it might have affected it and is not doing well. Now yet, let me show you something. Okay, this acro that you see up here, this is one of the last acros that I have gotten in this tank. And that's after the fact that I already knew and that I was dosing phosphates to bring it up, and I had started to feed my fish daily. So now that acro is doing phenomenal. As a matter of fact, feelers come out. Those little spots that you see on the top, like little buttons, shall we call it? Okay, those I'm noticing to have protrude more. So that's a sign of growth. But that acro is doing great. And the reason being, I'm assuming, is that when I got that acro, although I acclimate everything, I acclimate my corals, fish, inverts, and everything. But when I got that acro, I already was starting to feed reef to bring up the phosphates, and I was starting to feed the fish daily to bring up the nitrates. And here you have a full tank shot showing the changes that I've done when it comes to corals, and of course the new addition of the Gorgonia. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video, you found it interesting and educational. If you did, hit the like button, the thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel. And next to it, there's a little bell. Hit that. That's the notification button. So every time I upload a video, which is weekly, you'll be the first ones to be notified that I uploaded a video. And like I say at the end of all of my videos, happy reefing. Thank you very much for watching this video, and have a great, fantastic day. Bye-bye.